All right, never thought I'd see it like this, but here she is in her birthday suit. So this is just going to be a pretty short video. Just obviously the things that were left on it, like the suspension bits and all the other stuff. All right, here we go. A little bit of a snag here. Get the right and the left
fork tubes, got them off the bike okay. So there's two Allen keys. These are, or Allen bolts, I should say. They're 8mm. That's not where they're from, but they kind of look like this. And the ones here in the bottom have a little aluminum crush washer to seal inside there, just to make sure the oil doesn't come out. Anyway, these have been so grossly over-torqued that they're starting to strip. And this is just an 8mm Allen that goes in here. Before you can take the inner tube out, you've got to get this bolt out, and this bolt is starting to strip. So that's a serious problem. I don't know how I'm going to tackle it. The only thing I can think of is to just keep trying with the Allen bolt until it strips. And then once it strips, I'll end up drilling it out. I'm just going to have to just destroy the bolt in order to get the inner tube out. And that's really the only recourse that I have. And then, of course, after that, that bolt goes into a dampener rod in here. It's got just a long steel rod that connects up here. So this is what I'm up against right now. And there's no other option. That has to come out in order to get the seals out. And so that way I can clean up these tubes, the outer tubes and the inner tubes, replace the seals, replace the oil, and then put them back together again. So I'll do it off camera because it's frustrating. The only recourse is to keep trying at that bolt. And if I strip it, then I'm just going to have to drill it out. And that's really all there is to it. And then I have to deal with the broken bolt on the inside of the dampening rod. And that's in case of both of these. So that's probably one of the last problems I have, because the bike is disassembled. I've got some stuff on the engine, obviously, that needs to be taken apart. That's this. I'm going to work on it off camera. Come up with a solution. And when I get it done, I'll record it and talk about how I got this sorted out, if I got it fixed or not. The other option is to buy new forks, but it's not something I want to do. I want to keep the bike as original as possible. So, back to getting these races. See if I can zoom in here. So there's some scoring on that one. It's not as bad as what the swing arm bearings are. The swing arm bearings were shot. They're grinding and cracking and crunching and everything. So, and the races are scored pretty bad. But there's some marking on these ones. Look at the top part of the steering head off. These bushings are pressed in there, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to get those out. But the plan is to get this vapor blasted, get it looking good as new, and then possibly another clear coat over this, because that's what Yamaha did. It was basically just has a shot clean finish. There's a lower one. I might clean that up a little bit. So one thing I have absolutely zero interest in is messing around with tires. These rims, I haven't decided whether or not I'm going to tackle cleaning them, stripping them myself. There's a bit of corrosion, as you can see. Overall, they're in really good shape. They're just faded. The paint's faded. That was a really nice bright gold. And then there's some corrosion on the rims themselves. So there's a time to throw in the towel. There's a time to say, I don't have any interest in doing that, but we'll see how it goes. I'll try it myself, and if I can make a jig that makes the finish look OEM, then I'll do it. But if it starts looking stupid, then I'll just take it to the professionals and have them restore the wheels, because they do a fantastic job of making these things look brand spanking new. And then once that's done, it's just a matter of putting a new set of tires on them, and they'll be ready to go. So that's where I'm at with that. So I'll be painting this here in the garage. And once that starts, that's the beginning of the real restoration. This teardown is just, obviously, it's a lot of work. You're finding things that are wrong or broken or rusted, and it can be a little bit of a downer. But once she starts going back together and you see everything starting to go back and it's clean and all properly greased and probably put together and bolts are properly torqued and the right parts are in the right place, then it's a good thing. So I'm looking forward to that. Some of the other parts I got, and just had a look at the swing arm. There's just some surface corrosion over there again from the battery. Center stand, I think what I might end up doing is having somebody powder coat that. All right, that's it. Stripped down to the frame, ready for paint stripping, sandblasting, whatever it's going to be. Haven't figured it out yet. yeah, we'll start working on putting it back together again. Thanks for watching.